And then this is called a Fit PC computer. That's what we're running BeastBars on, is just this little guy here. BeastBars is fairly processor intensive. It's understandably what it's trying to do, but that's a nice little computer. What we race with is that one, trim, which is bow, up or down, and heel, which is self-explanatory. And then up on this one, we got rake and forestay. They stay there all the time. We got shroud load, which is that tax, so it's always the leeward shroud load. And then we have the times here alternating the times to the mark. Got the laptop, and everything runs on there. What's been really great about working with Brava Systems is they have the manpower and flexibility and know-how to customize our system. So we have three cameras in the boat, two main cameras and a dip camera up forward. And when the VSPARS processes the data, we send it onto Brava Systems, and Bravo can then send it to PDAs. This obviously takes a little coordination, and to have them be able to do those mappings for us and get it all organized at the beginning of the season is really great. Occasionally the trick is when to bring a little seat of the pants some flair into it, because the numbers aren't quite telling the truth. I grew up sailing dinghies in Southern California, and then a lot of Olympic class sailing, lasers and 49ers and whatnot, but I started navigating at One World Challenge for the America's Cup campaign in 2001. I guess my background is I have a math degree, but it's not so much about that as that I just really love sailing, and this seemed to be a good fit for my skills. There's a lot of things. One is there's just a sporting element. I mean, it's pretty wonderful to be outdoors and to just have the wind in your hair and the sun on your face and get to exert a little bit. I don't get to exert as much on this boat as on some other boats, so I miss that a little on this boat. But probably the coolest thing for me about the whole game is it's a very wide game, and the playing field's different almost every day. So yeah, there are a few patterns here in Marseille that it's good to know about. Sometimes we've gotten those just right, sometimes we've missed out just a little at this regatta. But every day is just a little bit different, so the trick is to balance up looking back at all the data and all the memories and all the notes you have, and looking out the window basically and saying, well, is this running according to those patterns, so I'm going to march on a line that I know works, or is it a little different because of that cloud over there, or the waves are skewed, or the current's going the other way. And that part's really, really challenging and very rewarding. I guess it's especially rewarding when you get it right, and it's also quite satisfying to know that there's always going to be something to learn. To sum it up, the best thing I like about sailing is I will never be good enough. I always have something to learn. I'd like to win the MedCup again this year. I've only done that once, and I'd like to win it twice. I would also like to win the America's Cup, and looking forward to giving that a good go. And I'd like to sail around the world with my family.